Hi. Myself, Anand Toshniwal. I work at QVD42 as a Drupal developer. And today I'll be presenting on a multi-tenant conversation with Alexa. Okay. So let's start with a very basic one. Like a simple question might be sound like a silly one, but still, what is a conversation? Okay, yeah. So, is there do you know there are types of a conversation, or it's just a conversation when two people talks? Is it a conversation, or you make it? So, if something happens as a dialogue comes in, then it's a conversation. Yeah, exactly. Okay. So the starting at, so two people are involved in a conversation. One is saying like a user saying as a Alexa, set an alarm for 5 a.m. And Alexa gives acknowledgement as an alarm set for 5 a.m. So this type of conversation is called as a singleton conversation. In the conversations in which just single thing happens, like someone asks questions and in return of that, Alexa or other person gives an answer, that type of conversation is called as a singleton conversation. So there is another type of conversation, which is the multi-tenant conversation, where exactly the people involved in a conversation and it is a part of a dialogue. So interaction happens between two users, which is for the like multiple of time, like two or more than three questions are comes in a picture. So this kind of conversation is called as a multi-turn conversations. So at the starting, we'll be looking at the demo, like what we are expecting, like what we are going to demonstrate, and how. And after that, we'll look at how we're going to achieve it. So before that, today what we are going to demonstrate is like a Alexa integration with a Drupal commerce. So we'll be adding the products to the cart and reading the cart using the Alexa. Alexa, open Drucom.
Welcome to Drucom. What would you like to do?
Search products.
Let's find it. What are you looking for?
I'm looking for red wine.
Are you sure you want to add red wine in cart?
Yes.
Added red wine to the cart.
At this point, now the Alexa has already. At this point, the Alexa has added the product to the cart. Now we'll be checking using Alexa. We'll be asking Alexa to read the cart. Alexa, open Drucom.
Welcome to Drucom. What would you like to do?
Check my cart.
You have the following items in your cart. 1 red wine.
And now, so we have the site here. So previously the cart was empty, but now when we requested to the Alexa for the product, now the product is added to the cart. So the current conversation we saw, we done the direct search. So we called out directly the name of the product. What if someone goes for just a wine? So how we can handle that one? So we'll see the demo first, and afterwards we'll discuss how we can achieve that one. Alexa, open Drucom.
Welcome to Drucom. What would you like to do?
I would like to search some products.
Let's find it. What are you looking for?
Wine.
I found multiple matches. Where should I focus? Red wine? White wine?
White wine?
Are you sure you want to add white wine in cart?
Yes.
Added wine to the cart.
And now if you refresh the page, you will see the white wine is also added to the cart. So till now what we saw in the demo, it's the products which has a default products. So they don't have any variations or attributes involved in within them. So what if someone wants to add clothes to the cart? So if you want to add some t-shirt to the cart, you will have size and the color for that one. So we'll now go for the demo for the product with the attributes, how Alexa will handle that one. Alexa, open Drucom.
Welcome to Drucom. What would you like to do?
Search some products.
Let's find it. What are you looking for?
Casual shirt.
I found multiple variations. Which one should I select? Printed shirt, lined shirt, printed shirt.
Printed shirt.
Which color you want to select? Black.
Black.
Which size you want to select? Large, medium.
Medium would be perfect.
Are you sure you want to add in cart?
Yes.
Added casual shirt to the cart.
So if you see, like, using the Alexa for the e-commerce, we can achieve, like, for the every product, we can handle every product with attributes, without attributes. We can handle products, we can add to the cart, we can read the cart, we can remove the items from the cart also. So now we'll go with why multi-turn conversations are required and how we're gonna, what tooling is required and how we can achieve that one. Before that, what do you think about the demo? Is it good? Is it? Thank you. So now we have seen like a demo for the Alexa integration with the Drupal Commerce. But the question is, why multi-turn conversation is required in the first place? So anyone would be able to guess or tell some reasons why it required? Yep, exactly. Because as we saw in the first slide, if the singleton conversation involves just one, someone ask a question and give an answer to that one. But it cannot handle multiple questions. So, and in some cases, in some scenario, we require multiple questions to be asked. And then to get to a particular result, we have to ask the multiple questions to the user first. So that's why multi-turn conversations are required. So in case of Alexa, the Alexa model provides you with the singleton conversation at the first. If you install just the Alexa module and you do the configuration stuff, it will just provide you with the simple, normal singleton conversation where user speaks to Alexa first sentence and it will return an single answer for that one. So the main reason is multi-conversations are required within the Alexa is because it fails to determine the context. So let's say, consider scenario, the first slide. I'll move back to the first slide. So this slide, let's say user ask Alexa. So consider the scenario first, like we have the Alexa setup normal configuration, which is provided out of the box from the module. Now, we create one intent, and then user speaks to the Alexa, says, who founded Drupal? So in a code we have configured for that answer, let's say Dries founded a Drupal. Now when user again try to ask about the Dries using the Alexa will not have a context regarding who we are talking about. That's why multi conversations are required, because they keep the context in the dialogue. So in a singleton conversation, each query is a brand new query. So as per the previous example, who founded a Drupal? So Dries founded a Drupal. Now when the user asks for the second question, where does he live? So now Alexa won't be able to figure out whom we are talking about. Are we talking about a Dries or a Drupal or something else? So Alexa doesn't know with whom we are talking. That's why in the single conversations, each query is a new brand query, and that's where multi-turn conversations come in place, because they keep the context, and that's why the dialogue keeps going. And as per the scenario of the add to cart functionality, if you want to add a product to the cart, same thing, you need to ask multiple questions to your user first to determine which exact product you need to add to the cart for the user. If everything comes in the one query, let's say someone says that I need a wine quantity 1 and please add it to the cart for me, Alexa. Now everyone will not do it, and it will be a long sentence, and till you say that sentence, Alexa will get confused. So that's why you need a multi-turn conversation, so it provides a better voice interface for your application. Okay, everything is fine, everything is cool. Now, you have introduced a new voice interface for your app, but why exactly business want to invest in these things? Is there any reason? Sorry? Yeah, that can be the one reason, because user won't get frustrated if there are multiple clicks, they are clicking on the pages, going to redirecting, and then finally getting the answer for that one. And sometimes it happens, let's say you are searching product, you go to filter, everything you do, and at the end you won't find anything, because there is no product that you are trying to look for. So that is the one reason. Anyone else? No? First one, user don't have to learn, because conversations are something that we are doing from the child age. We are conversation, like in daily life we are doing the conversations. So nobody has to learn something to use this one, the voice interfaces. Second, enhanced user experience. Now, enhanced user experience in sense of, let's say you're you are through the voice UI, you are searched for some product, but you went to some, let's say you didn't find any result. Okay, but enhanced using the voice, there are some the library which provides the Alexa provides some functions like which are reprompt or some dialogue directives, which lets you ask user you want to go for this one or that one. So using those things, we can make it more conversational, make it more personalized user experience for the user, and that will enhance automatically enhance the user experience for your app. Better user engagement. So better user engagement in sense, you go to some page, you find some products, now you added to the added that product to your cart. Now generally on the websites, what we do, we show the pop-ups to the user. Let's say you want to add something or some or other things, but most of the people don't like the pop-ups and everything because they are already added to the cart. Okay, but with the voice interactions, you can redirect your user to some other products or related products through the UI. So and also you also user don't let's take one more scenario where user filters everything and at the end of the add to cart product, there is some ad pop-up or some other products click you have placed, which will open the other product or some offer is there. Now there is a possibility user will click on that promotion offer you have given, but it's not necessary that he will click on it. But through the voice interactions, you can lead your user to at least say yes or no about it. Let's say you ask through your Alexa app, you set it something, the skill, you set something like that. It will, once user add product to the cart, you set question for the user, do you want to check this promotion offer or not? At least user have to go for that one. Like user have to say yes or no for that one. So you can engage your user more better way. Personalization using AI. So in a personalization using AI, let's say so the Amazon Alexa internally, whatever the skill you have created and whatever the user is saying, it processes through the ML and AI thing. So when you type something and when you say something, in the comparison of both, the text search has limited words. But when you interact with something, the conversational statement have more words to it. So in the future, maybe not now, but you can pick up those words of the user and you can know your user for what they are for, and just not their behavior on the site. And you can give them a more personalization. Be an early adopter. So now many few companies are using this voice interactions interfaces. So you can, for your domain or your sector, you can use it, and then you can set a trend for those things, how the your voice interaction for your sector will go through. So there is an opportunity for businesses to use it first and set the trend for that particular sector. Don't play the odds, play the man. So that's what you can achieve through your the voice interfaces. I'm a big Suit fan. I hope someone will be there. So now we have seen what is the importance, what are the advantages, and the demo. Let's now get into how we can configure the Alexa with our Drupal Commerce site. For integrating Alexa with your Drupal site, so there is a module which is provided by Drupal community, which is Alexa module, that you need to install first. You need to create one skill on the Alexa side. We'll go for that in the after slides. And you need one site, which is a like a web hosted site somewhere on the server. And that, so the Alexa module provides you the configuration for the, so when you create the Alexa skill, it provides you with a Alexa skill ID. So that skill ID you have to enter in your Drupal site configuration for the Alexa. So before we look into the how to create the Alexa skill, we'll look at the components of the Alexa custom skill. Invocation name. So invocation is name is something. So before that, what are the skills? So Alexa skills are something like a in your Android Play Store, you have apps. So the same thing, the apps in Alexa developer console, they call it as a skill. So your app has a name. You touch it and then open it, right? Now, it is a voice conversational UI. You just need to say a name. So you set some name for your skill. In my case, I have set the Drucom. So every time I want to access to my store, my site, I say like Alexa open Drucom or Alexa start Drucom. Or any, there are many phrases you can say and invoke your skill. So that's the invocation name. Interaction model. Interaction model consists of like how the dialogue will go, like how it will proceed. So in our add to cart, when we are adding the product to the cart, so there are like multiple questions we have asked. So that is the interaction model. So user deals with, user goes, user says something, then Alexa returns something. So we have to create that model first in Alexa skill, and then we can use it on our Drupal site. So interaction model consists of these four types: intents, sample utterances, custom slot types, and dialogue model. Intents. Intents are corresponds to something that will perform an action for you. Let's say in our case, we have an add to cart as an intent. So I want to add some product to the cart, so I have named my intent as a add to cart. And sample utterances like I said, like I want to search some products, or I want to add it to the cart. So search product or just a product name. So these are the utterances. So and these utterances helps you to invoke your intents. So intents, kind of, you can just imagine them as something, a function, and the utterances is a something called, something which calls to that function. Custom slot types. So custom slot types are, sometimes Alexa provides you like built-in data types. So as we have data types, integer, numbers, everything. So Alexa, so Amazon provides the data types also. But there are some cases like attributes. The product attributes, color and everything, they are not in the Alexa, Amazon data type by default. So you create those custom slot types and then use it in your interaction model. So Alexa will know what you are referring to. Dialogue model. So dialogue models are like, which are used in the multi-turn conversation. We'll get to that once we are start with the how to set up the multi-turn conversations. So this is just the one screenshot of Alexa skill intent. So this is a add to cart intent. So name of the intent is a add to cart intent. Then the sample utterances are there. So I need to purchase and a commerce quantity. So commerce quantity is like a slot type. It's not a custom slot type because number is already, which is provided by the Amazon. So commerce quantity is there as a parameter, which is a slot. Then we have a multiple sample utterances for those. And this sample utterances doesn't have to be perfect. It's just, they are just like a training data for your training data for Amazon to figure out what exact intent you want to fire when someone says one of these phrases. So over the period, once the user starts to interact with your skill, then automatically these are not the only five which will invoke that particular intent, but if user says something differently, still an intent is the same, like a commerce quantity is there or commerce product in the world, it will automatically invoke this add to cart intent. So now we have, like, let's say we have set up all the Alexa and everything, but how does it exactly works internally? So when you say invoke Alexa app, like let's say we have done the like Alexa open Drucom, so it goes to the Amazon Alexa, then the Amazon Alexa processes that particular invocation. Now it will resolve the intent name from that based on the utterance. So we have saw like utterances are mapped to the intents. So once someone says some utterance from your skill, it will invoke the intent. So Amazon, so Alexa figures out the intent of your utterances and forward that to the Drupal. Now, so the endpoint in the previous slide, we have saw that there is an endpoint we have to set in the Alexa skill. Now, that on that callback URL, Alexa will send the request object, whatever the user have said. And then Alexa will check for the like if dialog state is completed or a confirmation status of the conversation is confirmed. If it's confirmed, then it will respond with the SSML form from Drupal. So SSML stands for synthesis speech markup language. So whatever the output, let's say we are added the cart and then the conversation is completed, the product is added to the cart, and then we said like Alexa says that product is added to the cart, so at that point the dialogue state was completed and the confirmation state was confirmed. That's why at the end it responds with the SSML from the Drupal side. And in case if the conversation is not completed, then it will respond with a dialog delegate event and delegate the response handling to the Alexa. So in this case, the dialog delegate will look in the next slides in the more detail. So whenever the request comes from the Alexa side, Amazon side, then it creates an event on a Drupal side. And we can subscribe to that particular event and do the customization and turn like a product, add a product or some other functionality, whatever we want from the skill. So Alexa account linking with the custom skills. So now you have to like for adding product to the cart, you need to find out which user you are adding product in your cart. So we already have a blog about it. We'll not go in much detail. So step by step process is given here, which will follow the configurations of the OAuth server, and it will communicate with your Alexa endpoint, Alexa skill, and find out the access token, and from that it can get the user details at the end. So once you are done with all the configurations for the account linking, in your Alexa, Amazon Alexa app, you will see your skill there, and there is a line will be there that account linking is required for the particular skill. Once you click on the enable to use, you will be redirected to your site, and then you have to authorize the request. And once you authorize the request, the skill will be successfully linked with your Amazon Alexa skill. So dialogue directives. So the Amazon provides the dialogues to achieve the multi-turn conversations. So there are four types of dialogue directives: delegate directive, illicit sort directive, confirm slot, and confirm intent directive. In a delegate directive, Alexa takes care, takes care of like choosing the questions from your skills, and it will send it back to the user. So user will answer that questions. And if you set the particular skill question as a required one, and until and unless that that slot is fulfilled, it will keep asking that question to the user. Illicit slot directive, it's like a more controlled directive, in which in this particular directive, developer will have the access over like a which slot you need to get the answer. So you will let's say in our case we wanted the quantity, so we'll send back to the Alexa, says that we need a commerce quantity for the particular product, and Alexa will ask question related to that particular thing. Confirm slot. So confirm slot's more, it's like the slot is there, the quantity slot. If user doesn't give an input for the quantity slot, then it will reprompt the user with how many number of products you want to add to the cart. And confirm intent directive is something like you completed the add to cart product process, and you have invoked the confirm intent directive. Then it will just ask like you want to again add product to the cart. So it more of like it will invoke the same intent. Do you want to invoke the same function or not? So now we know that there are four directives are there and everything. So how do we make this work? So first step is building Alexa skill, and second is configuring Drupal site. So there are some requirements for that, which needs to be there. So you can build the Alexa skills and use it on a Drupal site. So building an Alexa skill. So there is a Amazon Developer Console where you create your skill, and then you build the interaction model and point it to your Drupal site. And while configuring the Drupal site, you will need a web accessible server and SSL certificate. Without that, the Alexa doesn't communicate with your local host. Then you need an Alexa module and one custom module to handle the Alexa event. So Alexa, whenever user says something, Alexa fires an event, then you can subscribe to that particular event and perform your actions, like add to cart or something, whatever the customization you want to do. So now we'll see how the dialogue directives work for the add to cart intent. So when we say the open Drucom, Alexa responds with what are you looking for it, and let's find it. But it also sends a dialogue illicit slot. So illicit slot at the first time it will just send all the slots. For example, like a quantity, then which variation required and everything, as a null, set it to the null. And when we ask for Alexa ask for what you are looking for, it will look for the value for your product name at first. So that dialog illicit slot is a variable as a parameter for your product name. So user will say, for a particular, I'm looking for a so and so product. So now Alexa knows what exactly the product name variable has the value. So it sets whatever the user say, like let's say I said, I'm looking for a shirt. Now at this part, Alexa will set the product name value to the shirt. And next step, how many products, On next step, it will ask for how many shirts you want to add to the you want to purchase. And it stores the quantity, and at the same thing, it will set the quantity variable to whatever the user says, like 2 or 3. And at the final, it asks for, are you sure you want to add this much quantity of this product to the cart? And it will be, once user says yes, it will be all those three things as combined parameter. In your custom module, you will look for the particular variation by given parameters from the user, and you will add that particular product to the cart. So we'll just see a one functionality code, which is add to cart. Is it visible code? Is it visible now? Okay. So when user says invoke your skill, let's say Alexa open Drucom, it fires out the event which is provided by the Alexa module. I have subscribed to that particular event, and now I'm looking at the current dialog state. If it's just started, then I'm adding one session attribute to keep track at which step I am in Alexa skill. Then I'm sending a response back to the Alexa skill with a dialog as a illicit slot and the slot name, the product name. So I'm telling Alexa that in the next question, I need to capture product name from the user. And I'm responding, and at the respond, I'm saying that, let's find it. What are you looking for? So next time user says I'm looking for shirts. So shirt will be set as a product name. And again, whenever, in the next sentence, as a user said, I'm looking for the shirt, it will again fires that particular intent. And at this state, the dialog state will not be started. It will be in progress. So I'm looking for, it's not equal to started, and it's not equal to, the dialog state is not equal to completed. And then I'm looking for that particular product, like a shirt. I'm querying that particular with the database and retrieving the result, and whatever the types of shirts I have, I have in the database, those are getting fetched, and in the next, and I'm sending that particular thing to Alexa, so Alexa will give those names to the user, and user can select next steps from that one. And the same thing will continue till all the slots are filled by the user. And once those are filled, we'll be able to get the product ID which we are looking which user is looking for, and that will be added to the cart. Anyone have any questions around this? Yes. The Alexa is a contributor module, but it doesn't support the library which used by the Alexa module. It doesn't support the multi-turn conversation yet. I have written the code about it, but I need to like do the final touches to the patch. And once that done, I'll be contributing that particular patch to the Alexa library. Thank you.